Hey YouTubers, well I went ahead and I put the pilot holes to where all the holes have to be cut, even in here, okay? And then I cut off that corner plate that's going to go up here. Let me take a look at it real quick. It's coming along. I'm letting it cool right now. Nice and easy, slow and easy, people. Got it on that drill there. Why don't we take a look? I got oil. I'm using 123, 321. Yeah, whatever. On your back, on your belly, just like I said in the core. Of course, let's be aware of safety. Got the glasses on. Aware of my surroundings. So let's give her a shot. I'm running it at that speed, about 550, 560. Now I don't go and I don't want to overwhelm it, punch it down nice and slow. Go on the depth a little more. Okay, now here we go. It's loud, but I don't put much pressure on it. So when I see the smoke, that means I got a lot of pressure on it. Well, that went really well. Took a little while to do. Not bad though. But I'm into making sure that it's patience that pays off. But you see the cut, it's nice. I got the holes already in there. And there it is. Now this is the end that the blades will be coming out. This will be for the shaft for the blade, okay? And then, like I said, I got all these holes now done with a pilot hole. I still got to get this and that center cut here. They all got pilot holes already I put in there and drilled out. So, what's left after that is getting this cut plasmaed off, and then on top of it cutting the holes. And since it didn't go so bad and I was running the RPMs pretty low on that drill press, yeah, that works out good. So I'm gonna go ahead and do it for this one. Next one though, I'll have it all put on a CAD drawing, and hopefully, you know, well, I'll have some good cuts, but the kerf, whenever I want to talk about, whenever you're using a plasma cutter or a laser cutter, plasma, laser, whatever, you have a left-handed kerf cut. That means it's cut at an angle, okay? So that right there, you're going to have to machine off or do like my buddy Orlin did and set up a grinding system the way he did. It was pretty awesome. You got to go check it out. All right, there you go. End cap's ready. Just got to put the deal on. I'll be back. Okay, now I got the bearing on the end cap. This is the way she's going to look, people, on her. This right here came out pretty good. So, show you the bottom. Enough clearance there. And then what I'm going to do, of course, I'm not going to have this bearing in here when I do this, but I'm going to be tacking on these nuts, welding them. And that way they're a permanent fix to the plate. And then I can replace the bearing just by removing the bolts. See? removing the bolts in. Boop, boop, boop. But I got a lip on this. Everybody's probably saying, why has he got oversized? Well, that's because when I go to weld this, I want to be able to run my bead so it washes right in here. Now, I'm going to have this set in laid down position. So I'll be doing some flat welding with stick welding, okay? So, yeah, I want to run my bead so that it washes right into that plate and there's no real big undercut or cutting into that material. It'll be permanently on there. But also these nuts will be on the plate on the other side, underside, and then I'll just be able to take these right off, you know? Get me a wrench and... Of course, you know, you guys know that. So, there you go. And I got this yet to work on, and I'll show that in my next video when all this is complete. All right, have a good one, YouTube.